Oh, thank you. Hello. I stopped making like all forms of content like maybe 3 years ago. I lost a lot of passion. Woke up one day, felt the vibe to make something like this. So I stopped wearing makeup. I mean, at one point I was doing it literally every single day for a few years. And I was actively trying to improve in my art because that's what I thought that I wanted to do as a career. And then I just stopped. And then life got tough when I turned like 18. As most people, you start adulting. But my family moved away, we shall say, and I kind of had to support myself like an adult. And then I didn't have any time because I was working so much and at such a low wage. Like, I wasn't making enough money to make the hours I was putting in worth it. So I stopped doing art. But also, I don't really use like a specific brow product. So I just use an eyeshadow from the Lunar Beauty. What is this? Nude Prism Palette. I'm figuring out the passion that I used to have for things. So I believe those are two different shapes. Completely different shapes. I still do makeup. I don't know, because being trans, obviously, I do my everyday look and stuff, but that does not include eyeshadow. I'm genuinely curious where my like eyeshadow skills are gonna come out of. Don't know where they're gonna go. I usually just do like eyebrows and mascara. It's kind of about it. At one point, I was wearing like fake eyelashes every day. Like, I simply do not have the time for that anymore. Who does? I don't know, but I'm jealous of you. We're gonna take a second to like finish these brows because I can't talk while I'm doing them. Well, those are my brows nowadays. They're a lot thinner than they used to be, but still as bold. Like 90% sure I got. Oh, yep. Concealer on my sleeve. That's just wonderful. Great. Gonna do some eyeshadow. No idea what I'm gonna do, but we're gonna see how it goes. I wanna do some color. I'm gonna use my old dusty but favorite 35B from Morphe. This is still one of my favorite fucking eyeshadow palettes. But on the topic of like nostalgia and like sensory stuff, the Euphoria era of TikTok, I think. Like, I'm not on socials very much anymore. I deleted TikTok a while ago, but I remember when I first got TikTok, like Euphoria, like this. Still don't know my name. That shit, that's the era. Like, those are vibes. Like, the colors of that era of TikTok, the like.
Dark, like, kind of emo, but.
Let me know if you can relate. Because, boy oh boy. This is the same concealer that I used to carve out my brow bone. So, I'm just blending it into that and kind of connecting the two. Already from the base, I can just tell that my right eye is going to turn out a hell of a lot better than my left eye, but that's fine.
Sisters, not twins, am I right?
since I'm talking about euphoria and like the vibe, that's what I want to do. I don't want to do euphoria the characters. Like, I don't want to do a Maddie base look or a Jules base look. Like, I want to do a look, an eyeshadow that is the feeling and the colors of euphoria.
Oh, she's so cute and aesthetic.
So we're going to throw in some pink, some purple, some blue. All that jazz. So on a fluffy blendy brush, I'm going to put this somewhere. I don't really know where. I don't think I even want to talk through this.
A few moments later.
Okay, this is the eyeshadow. You can't really see it, but I put the Euphoria glitters, like their Lemonhead LA glitters. I put it on my brow bone and I put it in the crease. I'm thoroughly impressed. I did not think I could whip something like this out. The eyes, they're not totally even, but like, not fucking bad for not touching eyeshadow in Lord, who knows how long. This is the only thing that makeup wipes are good for, but cleaning up after you've done some heavy eyeshadow. Because Lord knows, if you start blending your foundation and your base like normal, you're gonna get some crazy looking colors underneath from the amount of fallout on this bitch. Let's just see how much is on this makeup wipe after cleaning it up. Ta-da! I guess it wasn't as bad as I was making it out to be, but... Oh yeah, and I put Houdini in the crease. Can you see it? Oh yeah, you can kind of see it. Very pretty. It's the same colors as my nails. Now my base is always... So my base is always odd, but always put on a moisturizer before. I'm running out, but this is the CeraVe Daily Moisturizing Lotion that I've been using like forever now. And I put some of this on before I did my eyebrows and my eyes. But then I wipe some of it off, so I'm just going to make sure that I put some underneath my eyes to replace what I wiped off. Let that soak in. And I used three different beauty blenders. I use the Real Technique ones. And then this is one that I got in like a BoxyCharm a while back. Alexi Sponge. Doesn't really matter, but the Real Technique ones are really, really good. And now you can go in with like your prime routine, priming, whatever you want. Because we're trans girly and have a lovely 5 o'clock shadow. So because I pluck it, mine's not nearly as bad as some others might have, I'm blessed. But I use a color corrector to like cancel out the blue and green undertones.
Definitely skipped over a few parts, but that's because I started talking like this was a makeup tutorial, of which it's not. So, don't follow along.
Now we're looking real orange. We're gonna get rid of it. I just found my eyeliner. It is good. Okay, maybe I use that, which is really dangerous because I'm not going to be able to fix it once I do. Okay, we're going to go in with a cream blush. This is Dominique Cosmetics. We're going to take a blender, dab in. Oh, okay. So maybe. Now we're going to center this at the very, very top of our cheekbones and on our nose. Oh. Changing the blender. I didn't like that at all. I put contour, like the pre-contour and blush shades on my nose because it adds more depth to my face, I feel like, and it's easier to contour and carve out later. Now we're gonna get to highlighting. I'm gonna go over the places that I color corrected just to give it a nice base. Look at that. It's like the perfect shade. Totally matches my... Maybe a little orange, but again, we fix it with concealer. Really full coverage. Wow, that's pretty. Damn. Okay, maybe I won't even need concealer. I'm actually really loving this base. This is the e.l.f. 16 Hour Camo Concealer, and this is the matte one. Shade Fair Warm. Whoop. Whoop. Just gonna do a little more. Right here. Right here. This is gonna carve out my cheekbone a little more. And then you want the tiniest amount on your forehead. Moving on to powder and like setting this bitch. I use the Fit Me Loose powder. Always been a favorite. And this is the fairest one. And this is just for highlighting. So I dab into my loose powder. And then I dab onto the back of my hand. And it gives a like really smooth finish on it. And then you go straight into where you crease the most. I use this giant Sephora, what is this, a pro palette? Once Upon a Night palette. Literally the only thing that I use this thing for is the bronzer and the blush shades. It's the only thing good about it. Now that we have all this on, we're caked up and your face feels stiff. So you want to add some more moisture back into it.
This is how much of an intellectual I am.
Melt it in with a setting spray. To me, this is necessary. I use a blow dryer. Now you do one of my favorite parts. That is the highlight. Now I know that we kind of got over the whole like really bright blinding highlight like a while ago. Personally, I still love it. I forgot my nose contour. It's fine. I like to take this small, fluffy round brush. I don't know what I'm even saying. And do my inner corner highlight on my eyes. That is so important. I can't stress enough how much I fucking love an inner corner highlight. Now I'm gonna finish the eyes. Get back to you shortly.
I did my lips off camera. I got tired of editing and listening to me talk, so this is what you get.
This is the finished look. I'm thoroughly impressed with myself. I did not think I'd be able to pull something like this off, to be honest, but this base is really nice. The lips. The eyes. Anyways, that's all I got. I'm not gonna tell you to do the whole like comment shit, like either you liked it or you didn't, either you watched it or you didn't. Either way, I hope you, I'm just gonna say bye. Bye.